How should we add two fractions that have different denominators? To answer that question, let's review what a fraction is. A fraction means a whole is divided into equal parts. The denominator of a fraction tells us the number of parts in a whole. In our example, one whole is divided into 6 equal parts, and the other whole is divided into 4 equal parts. The whole that was divided into 6 parts has more parts than the whole divided into 4 parts. To add two fractions with different number of parts that have different denominators, we have to find a way to make each denominator or number of parts in a whole the same in each fraction before adding. This is where equivalent fractions come handy. And to review what is an equivalent fraction, watch our video about equivalent fractions on our channel. In our example, each whole needs to have 12 equal parts, so we can rewrite both fractions as equivalent fractions with the same or common denominator. Thus, we can rewrite 5/6 as 10/12 and 1/4 as 3/12. As each fraction now has the same denominator, that is number of parts in a whole, we can add our parts together. 10/12 plus 3/12 equals 13/12. And that we can write as a mixed number of 1 and 1/12. To find common denominator, we have to find what is known as least common multiple. Let's see how we can do that. In our example, we have one fraction with 6 in the denominator, and the other fraction has 4 in the denominator. Let's list multiples of 4 and 6. So we have 8, 12, 16, 20, and 24 as multiples of 4. And for 6, we have 12, 18, 24, 30, and 36. If we look closer, we notice that number 12 and number 24 appear as multiple, both for number 4 and number 6. So, number 12 and number 24 are common multiples for number 4 and 6. And what does it mean to find least common multiple? Least means that we have to use for common denominator the smallest number that is a common multiple. 12 is smaller than 24, so number 12 is the least common multiple for 4 and 6, and we will use it as a common denominator. As we said before, to add 5/6 and 1/4, we will have to represent those fractions as equivalent fractions with a denominator of 12. To do that, we have to multiply 6 in the denominator of the first fraction by 2, as 6 times 2 is 12. Since we multiply the denominator by 2, we also have to multiply the numerator of this fraction by the same number, so we multiply 5 by 2. The denominator in the second fraction needs to be multiplied by 3 to have 12. As we multiply denominator by 3, we have to multiply numerator by 3 as well. 5 times 2 is 10. 6 times 2 is 12, and that gives us 10 over 12 for the first fraction. 1 times 3 is 3. 4 times 3 is 12. So we have 3 over 12 for the second fraction. Now we have fractions with the same denominators, and we can add them by adding numerators only. So 10 plus 3 is 13, and the denominators stay the same. Thus, 5/6 plus 1/4 is 13/12, or 1 and 1/12.